Hello everyone, I welcome you all for today's class on digital signal processing. We'll cover the fifth module, that's on digital signal processor. I am Mahadevas, assistant professor, department of ENC, Gosse College of Engineering, Ramnagar. So these are the contents present in this digital signal processor: digital signal processing architecture, digital signal processing hardware unit, fixed point format, floating point format, IEEE floating point format, fixed point digital signal processor, floating point processor, FIR and IR filter implementation in fixed point systems. So these are the topics present in this particular module which we'll be covering. But in today's class, we'll be covering the topic on digital signal processing architecture and DSP hardware unit. First, let us go to the DSP architecture, what we are going to cover. So what is this digital signal processing processor there? So digital signal processor have a special feature that requires operations such as fast Fourier transform, filtering, convolution, and correlation, and a real-time sample-based and block-based processing. These are the important features which are present in this digital signal processor. Because in digital signal processor, we know that a fast computation is required for the large number of datas, or a filtering is required. So all this kind of operations are present in this digital signal processor. These are some of the features which has enlightened here today. Okay. Now, what kind of an architectures are there in this processors? Let us see. The first one what we have is general microprocessor based on von Neumann architecture. So there is a classification of the architecture. One is von Neumann architecture, another one is Howard architecture. Now we'll just cover von Neumann architecture. Now you can observe this figure one. This is a general microprocessor based von Neumann architecture, what you can observe here, which covers address generator, program control unit, IO device, arithmetic unit, program and data memory. And if you observe that, this is sharing the information. Okay, so this is the important concept present in the von Neumann architecture there, what we have. A von Neumann processor, it contains a single shared memory for the program as well as for a data, and a single bus for memory and the memory access, and an arithmetic unit and a program control unit, what it has there. So if you observe this von Neumann architecture, it has shared memory and a single bus structure. Now, due to this, what happens is that it performs a serial operation. So the processor proceeds in a serial fashion in terms of fetching and execution of the cycle. What's the meaning of this is that since it is having a shared memory as well as the program memory, what happens here is that in order to access the data, it has to execute a serial fashion there, or one after the another, it has to execute. So this is the operation what is being carried out in the von Neumann architecture, what you can observe. So when the instructions are executed, it has two parts in that. One is called as an opcode, another one is called as an operand. Okay. So the opcode, what it does is that it specifies what kind of operation the CPU has to do it. That is, the opcode specifies what the operation is, that is, tells the CPU what to do there. So the CPU comes to know what kind of an operation has to be done by that particular microprocessor there. Then the operand gives the information what kind of a data operation has to be done on the operand. Okay. So the instructions, what it does is that it modifies either the memory location or the IO devices there. So these are the simple operations which are carried out. So after an instruction is completed, the cycle will resume for the next instruction. As I said, since it is sharing the program and data memory along with the address bus, so the processor has to wait for the current operation has to be completed. Once the operation or the instruction execution is being completed, then only it can go for the next instruction. So what happens at the time is that the processor has to go to the wait state there. So when it goes for a wait state, there is a lot of delay in that. So this is one of the drawback present in the von Neumann architecture, what you can just see. So since the processor proceeds in a serial fashion, it causes most unit to stay in a wait state. Okay, that's the important information what you can observe in the von Neumann architecture. So let us summarize what we have just studied in the von Neumann architecture. The von Neumann architecture operates the cycle of fetching and execution by fetching an instruction from memory, decoding it via the program control unit, and finally executing the instruction. These are the simple operation. What is this von Neumann architecture is executing there. So when execution requires the data movement, that is data to be read from or written to a memory, the next instruction will be fetched after the current instruction is executed. As I said earlier, the current instruction execution has to be completed, then only it goes for the next instruction. Okay, until then, the microprocessor will be in the wait state there. So this von Neumann based processor that has a bottleneck mainly due to the use of a single shared memory for both program instruction and the data there. Due to the shared information, it has to go to the wait state. So this increasing the speed of the bus, memory, and computational unit can improve the speed, but not significantly there. So if anyone want to upgrade this one, they can improve the speed by modifying the bus structure or a memory structure or the computational unit, but not significantly. So this is the sum of the important information of von Neumann architecture. One of the drawback of this von Neumann architecture because of a serial execution and going to the wait state there. Now to overcome this problem of this von Neumann architecture, there evolved a next hardware information that's about Harvard architecture. Okay, how this particular Harvard architecture looks. So this is the figure, what you can observe in figure 2 there. It's a digital signal processor based on Harvard architecture. So you can compare the previous figure and this particular figure. What we have, we have separate program memory, separate data memory, separate program memory data bus, separate data memory address bus there. So once all this information are separated, then what happens is that a parallel operation can be carried out. When this parallel operation is being done, then the processor need not go for a wait state there. It can go for the execution of the next instruction. So until the first instruction is completed, the second instruction will be decoding all this information. Okay, let us see in detail how this particular Harvard architecture is been working there. So to accelerate the execution speed of digital signal processing, the digital signal processor are designed based on the Harvard architecture. So this Harvard architecture, what is there? You can already see in the figure there. The DS processor has two separate memories. One is dedicated to the program code, while the other is employed for the data. That's the important information, what you can observe the difference between the von Neumann architecture and the Harvard architecture there. So in this way, the program memory and the data memory have their own connection to the program memory bus and data memory bus separately there. So due to this, the speed will increase. Okay. So this means that the Harvard processor can fetch the program instruction and data in parallel at the same time. So that's the advantage. And there is additional unit called as a MAC, that is multiplier and accumulator, which is dedicated hardware used for digital filtering operation. Okay, so when there is a specific hardware for performing this MAC operation, again, the speed is increased in this processor there. So another last hardware unit, the last additional unit which is being added here is shift unit. You can observe here shift unit is used for scaling operation for floating point implementation when the processor performs digital filtering. That's the important thing what you can observe, how it is increasing the speed of the Harvard architecture. So that's the advantages what you can observe there. Now, already we have seen the architecture, we have compared also. Let's summarize that von Neumann architecture versus Harvard architecture, what we have there with the help of certain waveforms execution there. So let's compare the execution of two architectures. The von Neumann architecture generally has the execution cycle described in this figure 3. So this figure 3 you can observe is the execution cycle. And you can observe that until this particular instruction has completed the operation, the second instruction is not getting started. So once the first instruction is executed, execution is completed, the second is fetching. When second instruction is executed, third is fetching. So it is performing a serial operation there. The first cycle obtains the opcode from the memory, and control unit will decode the instruction to determine the operation, as we already discussed. Next is the execution cycle. Based on decoded information, the execution will modify the content of the register or the memory. So this is about the von Neumann architecture, what we have there. Okay. If you observe the execution cycle of the Harvard, what is the changes? You can observe it. So let us see in the von Neumann architecture. Once this is completed, the processor will fetch the next instruction, as we can see it from the figure there. So the processor operates one instruction at a time in a serial fashion in von Neumann architecture. What about in Harvard? As it is in the figure, you can observe, once the first instruction is fetching and is going for execution, the second instruction will fetch. It means what? When the first instruction is executing, the second instruction is fetched. So it is not disturbing the previous instruction there. In this way, the pipeline operation is performed and the processing speed is being increased efficiently. So to improve the speed of the processor operation, the Harvard architecture takes the advantages of common DS processor, in which one register holds the filter coefficient while the other register holds the data to be processed, as depicted in the figure 4. You can observe here, it's performing the parallel operation here. So the Harvard architecture in detailing explanation, as shown in figure, the execute and fetch cycles are overlapped. We call this as pipelining operation. Pipelining means going or executing simultaneously. So the DS processor performs one execution cycle while also fetches the next instruction to be executed. Hence, the processor speed is dramatically increased, as we have discussed there. Okay, so the Harvard architecture is preferred for all DS processor due to the requirement of most digital signal processing algorithms, such as filtering, convolutions, fast Fourier transform, which need repetitive arithmetic operations, including multiplication, addition, memory access, and heavy data flow through the CPU. So these are some of the important operations which are required for the digital signal processor and algorithms what are being executed or what can be easily executed with the help of this DS processor there. For other applications, such as those dependent on simple microcontroller with less of a timing requirement, we prefer for the von Neumann architecture, maybe a better choice, since it offers much less silica area and is thus less expensive. So wherever we go for the less silicon area on an IC or less cost, we prefer for a von Neumann architecture where the timing is not much important there. Okay. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon for further notification. Thank you.